students, good morning. Welcome to the online classes of RC Education Hub Mansur. And let's start class 11th biology chapter number 3 plant kingdom. So let's discuss about the next group, that is angiosperms. And before that we discuss about the algae, bryophyta, pteridophyta and gymnosperm. As we know that as we are going one level upward, complexity should be increased. Okay, so here let me discuss the some important features of the angiosperms. Let's start. As we know that angiosperms are the advanced plant because they having all the well developed systems. For example, one thing is that they are seed producing plants, they are flowering plants and the seeds are enclosed inside the fruit. Okay, second thing, they having the vascular bundles which are well developed. It means they having tracheids, they having companion cell, each and everything. So let's discuss angiosperms. These are the angiosperms are the plants which having seeds enclosed inside the fruit. It means the seeds are enclosed inside the fruit wall or inside the ovary. Okay, so this is the first feature of the angiosperm. Second thing is that they having well developed vascular bundles. Vascular bundles, it means xylem and phloem, which are helpful in transportation of food and water. Okay, they transport water and food. These angiosperms are variable in size. They are from microscopic Wolfia to the 100 meter height plant Eucalyptus. Okay, Eucalyptus. So it means they are variable in size. As well as if we discuss about that, these are flowering plants and flower is the main reproductive part of the plant. So as it is visible, these are the flowering plants. It means they can reproduce through the means of sexual reproduction. And if flower can produce both, it having both male and female sex organs. Okay, so let's discuss which are the male and female sex organs are here. So it is visible in the life cycle of angiosperms. Okay, so here is a plant which is well developed and it having the flower. It produce a male, it having a male sex organ which is known as stamen. Okay, and the stamen is consist of two parts, one anther which contains male part pollen grains which later on produce male gametes. Okay, and it is the another part which is known as female sex organ, and it is known as pistil. It is consist of three parts. Okay, one is stigma, another is style and ovary. Okay, so it is the female sex organ or female reproductive part. This female reproductive part inside the ovary, ovules are enclosed. Okay, which later on develop into the female gametophyte. So here let me discuss this anther produce pollen grains, and these pollen grains after maturation they released out, and out of four pollen grains, each pollen grain do not produce male gamete, they get degenerated, but only one pollen grain is functional, which is giving rise to the two male gametes. These are giving rise to the two male gametes. So here it is visible, these are microscopic mother cell or microspore mother cell which produce tetrad. It means each microspore mother cell produced four pollen grains. Okay, out of that three get degenerated and one is functional. Okay, so this is the structure of pollen grain here. It is consist of outermost layer exine, megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell later on became functional and it gave rise to the embryo sac. If we will discuss about the structure of embryo sac, then generally an embryo sac is consist of 7 celled and 8 nucleus. It is 7 celled and 8 nucleated structure, or we can say that it having 7 cells and 8 nucleus. Here are the cytoplasm get fused. So here are 2 nucleus and 1 cell. These are known as polar nuclei. Okay, it is egg apparatus, as it contains 2 synergids and 1 egg cell. Okay, and these are antipodals are here. Antipodals. Okay, so this is the embryo sac, which is 7 celled and 8 nucleated stage, and this is the structure of embryo sac. But what happened? It is the female gametophyte and here are male gametes. What happened? After that pollination takes place here. What is pollination? So when these pollen grains are transferred from anther to the stigma, when these pollen grains are transferred from anther to the stigma, it is known as pollination. Okay, so what happened after pollination? We will discuss once. This is the structure of female reproductive part. When these pollen grains released from the anther, these pollen grains fallen over the stigma. Okay, here due to some presence of some chemicals, they identify the pollen grains and pollen grains starts to germinate, and these pollen grains produce male gametes. These male gametes, now here formation of pollen tube takes place. Formation of pollen tube takes place, and this pollen tube moves through the style and it enters into the embryo sac. Okay, so here you can understand in this way that here is one pollen tube. Okay, it carry the male gametes, and these male gametes move through the style, through the pollen tube, and enter into the embryo sac. From where they enter? From the side where synergids and one egg cell is present. So as these two gametes enter into the embryo sac, the process of fertilization takes place here. Okay, and the fertilization takes place here is two types. How? One of the male gamete, which is released into the embryo sac, it gets fused with the egg cell. Okay, and one of the male gamete gets fused with the polar nuclei. When one of the male gamete gets fused with egg cell, male gamete fused with egg cell, it forms zygote, and this process is known as syngamy, and later on it produced embryo. Whereas second male gamete got fused with the polar nuclei, one of the male gamete gets fused with polar nuclei. Okay, and it is giving rise to the primary endosperm. Okay, PEN, primary endosperm or primary endospermic nucleus. Understand, this process is known as triple fusion. Why? Because two nucleus of the polar nuclei and one of the male gamete, they get fused. So here 3N is formed. It is known as triple fusion. As because two types of, so here what happened? One syngamy and one triple fusion, both are taking place. Fertilization takes place two times. That's why the process is known as double fertilization. Okay, the process is known as double fertilization. Okay, and this double fertilization give rise to the one embryo, which is, this is the well developed embryo. Okay, and another giving rise to the they produced seed. So this is the overall life cycle of the angiosperm, and these angiosperms are the most advanced plant. Later on they are categorized into two, monocots and dicots. Monocots and dicots. So monocots are those plants which having the single cotyledon. They having single cotyledon, whereas dicots having two cotyledons. Another thing is that these monocots having the parallel venation in their leaves. Parallel venation. What is the venation? Arrangement of the veins. For example, this is the leaves and the veins are arranged in parallel manner. So this type of is present in monocots, whereas dicots having the reticulate venation in their leaves. Okay, they having reticulate venation. Okay, after that dicots having taproot system. It means they having one main root and another lateral roots, whereas monocots having the fibrous roots. Okay, so these are the general differences between the monocots and dicots, and this is all over about the angiosperms. Thank you.